Hey, Carson Olinger here with Capital City Equity Group. I'm out traveling with one of my associates. We're evaluating some properties. So some of what I do is I mentor other people, and one of the guys I'm training, his name is Andy, came across a property up here in Hall County. That's actually a trailer park that they're wanting to sell. We found this through a dispossessory leads. We're gonna go walk through this neighborhood real quick. I can't get into the properties, but there's about 40 plus trailers in here, and we're gonna make an offer on this potentially to buy it, because we have the capital partners in place to do that. My name is Carson Olinger. I'm with Capital City Equity Group. My number is 678-478-2230. You can reach me directly at carson@capcityeg.com. So we're gonna flip the camera around here and kind of drive through slow, and I'm gonna show you some of the things we're looking for as we're looking at these properties. So one thing we're gonna do is count how many trailers there are. And we're gonna also look at the quality of the trailers. One thing I wanna see is, are these trailers retired? So you'll notice this trailer over here on the left, this yellow one, it's got a tongue on it. That's how you can tow the trailer. That tells me right away that the trailers are not retired. You see the stickers on them showing that these are personal property, much like a license plate on your car. They have to have a registration through the DMV. So these are real property. I'm sorry, these are personal property versus real property like a house. So you got two different components in here. See those stickers? Those are all, each year they have to get the taxes paid on them. I'm looking at the shingles on the roof. Do we have metal roofing, composite shingles? Are we skirted on the bottom, or are they mounted to the ground? We got some over here on the right. Okay, I noticed the roads are paved. I'm looking at the air conditioning units throughout. I'm looking at the roof, like I just mentioned. Are these individually metered? The answer to that is yes. Each one is metered on its own power and its own water. The other thing I'm looking at, and there's one right here, there's a pole with a community light. So that probably means there's power that we have to pay outside of the individual power to light up the community. So these would go into my overhead that I would take out of my gross rent. As we continue to look, you'll see there's some outbuildings that are here. Do those stay when people move out? I'm not sure. So we gotta look at all those things. Now down here to the right, it's gonna be a little hard to see, but this is an open drainage ditch. This is where all of the sewage from the septic systems run through there. And if you pan down there, you can kind of about the sidewalk. You'll kind of see where the fountains are that keep the water moving around. So this is totally legal. It's just a large septic pond. So the septic runs through several central tanks to get the debris out of it and the sediment. And then the liquids flow down there, and it's treated just like you would in a water treatment plant. So that's a little unusual. Be aware that when you're trying to finance these, that some banks might be a little leery of doing that. They have decent front porches on them, but just looking at these properties, there's three or four double wides in here, but most of them are single wides. So that tells me they're probably gonna be two ones or three twos on the small side, but a double wide could potentially be a 3-2 or a 4-2. Water in this community is included at $5 a week. These people all pay per week, and it's through money orders at the central office here on site with the property manager who lives here, who gets to live for free, but is also paid on top of that. So there's some work we got to do on here if we buy these, but typically, since this is 100% rented, we're just going to need to fix these up as people move out. There's nothing you need to do when you buy it. So as they move out, you've got to be prepared with about $15,000 to $20,000 of access or excess capital in which you can start fixing up properties, because you're gonna need to have access to that. So factor that in. It might even be more, maybe 40 to 50, just to be safe. So we'll look at this, we're gonna evaluate, we're gonna get the P&L, and then evaluate what the cap rate is and make an offer commensurate to what we feel is necessary to run this thing. Looks like over here, they had a recent eviction. So in a park like this, that's a good sign, because it's showing the tenants that you mean business. And so the management company here is actually following through with their dispossessories, which is how we found this property in the first place. So I'm down here at the dead end. We're gonna flip this around on me real quick. We're going to evaluate this, put an offer on it, and we're going to see where it goes. Our intention is to buy this property, and if we can, then once we buy it, we're going to probably start turning these over to owner finance deals. I got somebody behind me. I'm going to pull over here to the side, let them get through. So anyway, I'll post this to my YouTube page and Facebook. If you got any questions on trailer park acquisition, feel free to give me a call. My number again, 678-478-2230. You can reach us if you want to sell your house at NorthAtlantaHomeBuyer.com. If you're an investor and you want to reach out to us to gather information, you can reach out to me on my website for my investors at www.capcityeg.com. Thanks for joining us. I appreciate your time. Look for other helpful videos like this. Carson Olinger, Capital City. Take care.